Hi everyone, I'm Stephen King from Boltight. In this video, I will showcase the T-Series and the TSR Plus, the differences between them, and what their respective benefits are. I will also show you step-by-step on how to correctly install and remove these tensioners. So come follow me to the training room. So let's begin with the T-Series. We're gonna start with installation. And remember, this is the same process as we would use on the TSR Pluses. So you're going to screw the puller all the way down and then back it off about an eighth of a turn so that the tensioner is free to move around a little bit. The idea on a gasketed flange is to have at least 25% coverage. It gives you an equal loading on the flange, doesn't pinch the gasket. A nice little trick I like to do is I like to stick my thumb in the puller because it helps me control it a little bit better. All the way down and back off a quarter of a turn. The first piece I like to start with is the T-block, just because that's the most confusing part for most people. All of our couplers are gonna have a locking collar on them. Make sure that you hook that up and lock it. And then we're gonna bring this over here to our next T-block. And last but not least, locked collar. From here, we're gonna link all our hoses together. You're going to take this hose right here and bring it over to this nipple that's on the bottom side there. Remember to lock the collar. And you're going to notice when we come around to this last one, we're going to have two extra ports. Now, one of these is for the hose. The other is going to be for the main line. So there's our last interconnecting hose locked together. So you notice all four of our tensioners are hooked up. And the way we've got these linked, the hydraulic fluid flows both directions, so it'll go all the way around the flange. It'll come in here and go both ways. It just helps equalize the pressure out a little faster. So then I'll hook my main line on there, and we'll screw that over. All right, now we're gonna pressurize the flange. So as it pumps up, you'll see we're keeping our eyes on the pistons here, looking over all the pistons to make sure that they don't extend too far. You can see where this one right here is already coming up. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna come in with our Tommy bars and we're gonna turn the sockets to tighten the nuts. So once you get it there, you don't have to push on it real hard. You just kind of give it a little snug and that's all you gotta do. You don't have to put too much power on it. All right, so that's good and snug. And let's just assume we did all the rest of them. We don't have to do them right now. All right, go ahead and release. All right. Here's where we show our biggest difference between our T-Series and our TSR series. In order to retract the pistons back to zero, you have to manually wind down the tensioner to push the oil back into the cylinder. Now, right now, I didn't have to turn that one very far to do that because we didn't pressurize it very much, but sometimes it'll be very extended, and so it takes quite a bit of winding. So at this point, now that we've tightened these bolts, we would move to the next bolt in our pattern. And it's different with every bolt or with every setup. So this one we have 25%. So we would move it around quite a bit to tighten the flange. If we say had 50% coverage, we would only have to move it one more time. So this would be considered our A bolts and then we would move it to our B bolts and then we could move on to the next flange after that. So that's the installation process for both the T-Series and the TSR Plus. When it comes to removal, the process is a bit different. Let's head back to the training room and I'll show you how it's done. So if we came to this flange and we've put all these tools on here, but it's already tensioned up, we need to loosen the bolts. What we're gonna do to detension it is slightly different than what we did to tension it. So what we have to do is we have to leave enough space between the puller and the piston to allow some room for the nut to relax. So what we would do is we would install our tensioners the same way we did when we were tightening, but instead this time, instead of backing off an eighth of a turn, we're gonna back it off a full turn. So there's a couple ways you can do this. What I like to do is mark the spot and then back it around to back where I started. So that gives you a full turn loose. And then that's enough to allow the nut to relax. There we go. So when you pressurize, you're gonna notice a big difference is that the piston's gonna travel further because it's gotta give some room to take loose that nut. So go ahead and pressurize. I'm keeping an eye on everything, make sure that we're not overstroking the tensioner too far, but if you back it off a turn, it shouldn't overstroke at all. Got our hose clear here. We've got room to get to our socket. right here, we're going to start loosening, and you can feel it come loose. Now, you don't have to just back the nut off as far as you can. You've only got to go about two windows worth of rotation. So I just did that, one, two. And if we release, the tensioner should be loose now. Now, again, difference between the TSRs and the T-Series is the T-Series, we're going to have to reset the pistons to zero by winding the puller down. All right, and we got it all the way down there. We'll loosen it up, and now the stud's loose. See the stud's loose there now. All right, and we'll just repeat that with all these other tensioners before we release the pressure. Now let's talk a little bit about the TSR Plus. For this product, we've implemented state-of-the-art materials and technology, resulting in significant time savings during operation. Let me demonstrate how fast the TSR is in operation. What you're going to notice on these compared to the T-Series manual retract is you're going to see what gives us the SR Plus name. It's a spring return plus. So what this does is instead of us having to manually wind the pullers down to collapse the cylinder and evacuate the oil, we've built these tensioners with springs inside to help retract the tensioner automatically. So notice as we release the pressure, I'm not having to wind any tools down or anything like that. I'm just going to stand here and watch it. And you can see it's quite quick. Imagine if you have eight tools on here and you're having to wind each one down manually. I would still be working on the second one right now, and the fourth one just finished flattening out. So that's where the efficiency is. That's where the time savings is in these tensioners. All right, now that we've loosened all the nuts from the detensioning process, we can take the tensioners off. I like to start by taking the locking couplers loose. Just take the locking collar off. You don't have to take the hose just yet. What we're gonna do is work our way around. All right, now I like to take the lead hose off and get it out of your way so that you can just work with the interconnecting hoses and the T-block. And I don't have to unhook everything, because one of the nice things about our interconnect hoses is you can actually just wind them up. So if you pop one loose right there, let it hang, you can work your way around the flange and just coil the hoses up. Now you've got all your hoses in one bundle, no tangle. You can just move on to your next flange. We'll take our pullers out. Again, I like to put my thumb in the puller just so I don't drop it. It's not bad on a vertical flange like this, but when you're dealing horizontally, here, I'll show you in a second. You've got your thumb in the puller, it's easier to hold on to it. You don't drop it. So to summarize, the T-Series is a cost-effective solution, while the TSR Plus is a significantly faster tensioner. But no matter which solution you choose, you get a safe, reliable, and high-quality hydraulic tensioner. Both have high wear and corrosion-resistant surface treatment. And whether you choose T-Series or TSR Plus, tools can be connected in sequence, improving operational speed and ensuring even joint compression. Thank you for watching the video. I hope it was helpful.